the EEO-1 form.
This is a form that's required to be filed annually online with the Equal Employment Opportunity Commission. It is required to be filed by employers who have 100 or more employees. And it includes, as some of you probably know, data that's characterized with respect to race, ethnicity, gender, and job category for your workforce. It also applies to contractors, federal government contractors, and first-tier subcontractors with 50 or more employees and at least $50,000 in federal contracts. The form needs to be filed annually. The deadline is generally May 31st of each year. The reason that this is pertinent right now, there was an Obama-era initiative to add a component 2 to the EEO-1 form, which requires information about income in addition to minority classification or protected classification and job role. The idea is to look for the EEOC to be able to look at income information to identify pay disparities, particularly to address the well-established gender pay gap. So component 2 was proposed, there was litigation, now it's back on the table, and at this point, based on what's happened through the federal courts, employers with who are required to file an EEO-1 will be required to file what they're calling component 2 information, which is W-2 income information and hours worked for both 2017 and 2018 as of September 30th of this year. That's the deadline for 2017 and 2018 submissions. Component 1 still due May 31st of this year in the usual way. And this brings up, I think, something interesting, many of you probably have thought of this, which is at the same time we have the new Mass Equal Pay Act, which requires a self-evaluation by employers to look at specifically information that is related to the gender pay gap problem. And what the self-evaluation under the Mass Equal Pay Act requires is for you to put together this same kind of analysis. You don't have to submit it to any government agency, but if you do an analysis that looks at how much people are paid, what role they're in, how many hours they're worked, and other benefits, conditions in terms of employment, in order to be able to compare apples and apples and determine whether you have any pay inequity problems. And if you address those issues internally, then the Mass Equal Pay Act automatically provides you with an affirmative defense against a pay equity, a gender pay equity claim. So the EEO-1 form is moving in this direction. Massachusetts, as usual, has already moved in this direction of all of us to do this evaluation to combat pay inequity, particularly gender pay inequity.